Hey, how's it going? Dave2D here. So this is a video on 5 free Mac apps that I think everyone should be using if you have an Apple computer. So if you have an iMac, a Mac Pro, or any of the MacBooks, you should be using these apps because they're good, they're useful, and they're free. In addition to the 5 free ones, I'll be talking about some paid ones. None of these are sponsored or anything. These are just apps that I've used that I like, hence the creation of this video. So the first one is an app called Onyx. So Onyx is an excellent Mac cleaning tool. It's powerful, it's free, and it gets updated frequently. You can clean your Mac using some basic stuff like erasing caches and cookies, but it can also do some more aggressive cleanup like removing languages that you don't use. It can go pretty deep. Now, Onyx can be a little bit risky, like if you go ham and start erasing everything, you can mess stuff up. So if you want something a little bit more restrained, there's an app called Clean My Mac. It's also good, but it costs $40. I prefer Onyx just because it does everything you would need and it's free. The second app is App Cleaner. See, when you erase apps on Macs, they already do like a decent job just by deleting the DMG file, but there's often residual files and this application gets rid of them. One thing to keep in mind, you do need to have App Cleaner installed in advance. So if you already deleted a bunch of apps from your Mac, it won't be able to find those older residual files. You need to use something like Onyx to clean that stuff out. Next is Flux, or Flux, I'm not really sure how to pronounce it. It's an application that controls the color temperature of your screen based on the time of day, and it does this in a really gradual manner. So during the day, your screen will look normal, but as the sun goes down, it'll slowly remove the cooler hues from the screen to make it easier on your eyes. I know it sounds gimmicky, but try it for a while and I think you'll like it. The thing that it's not good for is color accurate work. So obviously things will look more orangey and warmer with Flux running at night, but aside from that, once you get used to the color temperature changes, it makes your computer experience better. It helps you work for longer because there's less eye strain, and for me, and I think for a lot of people, it'll help you sleep better after you've shut it down. Next is the Unarchiver, which I think is the best unzipping or unarchiving app. Even if you don't frequently use compression programs, install this thing because eventually you'll download something or someone will send you something that needs decompression and this will handle it. It does all of the major compression formats and it extracts them properly. It's lightweight and it's free. Last up is CopyClip. And this is an app that stores all the stuff that you copy using Command C. So imagine you copy one selection of texts and then moments later you copy some numbers or something. Normally you lose that first selection of texts. CopyClip stores them all into a list. So if you're typing essays for school or just doing stuff for work or just doing anything, having a functional history of text that you've copied with Command C is awesome. And once you've used this for a while, it's hard to go back to not having that kind of functionality. So these 5 apps so far are free. They're good. They're awesome. But I also want to talk about some paid apps. And again, not sponsored. This is just like stuff that I like. Okay, the first one is Duplicate Finder. And this, as the name would suggest, finds duplicate files. So if you have a giant archive of photos or videos or music, this thing will search through them, find duplicates, and then clean them out. It's pretty fast. And it also gives you good control for searching and erasing them. Sadly, it's not free. It's a $10 app. Now there's another app called Gemini 2 that's seemingly more popular, but it's 20 bucks and I've used them both. They perform like almost identically. So if you're gonna choose between them, I'd rather you guys save 10 bucks and get Duplicate Finder. I actually prefer it. I think the icon looks better. The other thing, if you're looking for a free option, well, I'm sure there's multiple free options, but the one that I've used with the most success in the past is something called Dupe Guru. So if you're looking for a free option, there's one for you. Okay, next up is Daisy Disk. It's also $10. What this thing does is analyze your drive and it shows you what kind of files are taking up space on your computer. So it's another cleanup tool and it does a great job at sorting out your drive into categories of what you have on there so you can kind of decide what you want to nuke. There are a couple free alternatives that I've used. So Grand Perspective is one, Disk Inventory is another. They all kind of do the same thing. Daisy Disk is a little bit prettier, a little bit faster, but whether or not it's worth 10 bucks is up to you. Okay, next up is AirMail. It's yet another $10 app. There are a lot of really good email apps for Mac. Even the stock mail app is pretty good. Now, I've tried most of the popular ones, and AirMail is my favorite. It boils down to customizability. You get full control in this app for how your mail is handled when it goes in and out, as well as full control of viewing and sorting your email. Also, I like the icon. I know it seems silly, but I like a good icon. Okay, lastly, if you're looking for a Photoshop alternative, because Photoshop is expensive, and if you don't want to pay that like monthly fee, the app that a lot of people get recommended is something called Pixelmator, and it's a good app, it's like 30 bucks, but there's another app that I think is much better called Affinity Photo. It's $50, quite a bit more expensive, but it looks, feels, and behaves much more like Photoshop for photo editing. Now, if you're looking for something that's free, you can get GIMP. It's also a very capable app for image or photo editing. And that's basically it. I hope you guys learned a thing or two. If you want to see one of these videos for Windows applications, give me 50,000 likes. Just let me know in the comments below. I'll do my best to make one of those as well. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thumbs if you liked it, subs if you loved it. I'll see you guys next time.